Williams' second runway shoe. This is interesting, isn't it? Have you heard the rumor? Supposedly that Matthew Williams might be heading to Gucci. Matthew Williams of Elite's fame, supposedly. I saw a tweet from a Brian Boy speculating that he might be. He just put out a little feeler, like, oh, is really Matthew Williams going to Gucci? Going to Givenchy, sorry. And now everyone's kind of wiling out in the comments. So that might be interesting, isn't it? I could really see him working well for Givenchy, especially if they're looking at it from the sense of kind of replicating or kind of building upon the Riccardo Tisci heyday, right? That kind of amazing era when he was like, you know, smash, you know, Rottweiler T era and stuff. That could be a good platform to do his thing. Especially if he decided to go to Givenchy and not reiterate and not kind of make another interpret and not kind of build upon the buckle, the seat, the belt buckle thing. Imagine if he just left that behind or left that to Elique Saint Dior, and he just built and he just made something, another kind of harness that was just amazing, that blew everyone's mind. Because for all the stick he gets for the seat belt buckle thing, like, you have to remember that he was the only person that did that, right? That was the first time I ever saw that in fashion. Yeah, you could have bought the same thing on Amazon, but no one was doing it. I remember Hiroshi Fujiwara was saying the same thing. Like, people say everything I do is easy, or that they could do it, but they didn't do it, right? I did it first. So it's like, yeah, that's where the skill comes in. The ability to take something mundane and then make it desirable. Yes, it was that kind of, you know, airport, airplane belt buckle thing is probably an idea that everyone that's kind of has taste or is into clothes or is into kind of fashion or is into streetwear would have had the idea of like, oh, this would work really good as a belt, right? When you're on your flight going somewhere, right? But then no one took the risk to kind of go home, research it, find a manufacturer, get them to make it into a belt and actually make it work. And then he obviously then went and did a bit of R&D and kind of designed his own belt buckle, which is kind of really unique, isn't it? I've got a bootleg version somewhere that I wear mostly. That's really nice, but I'd imagine the real version is probably even better. But anyway, back onto Matthew M. Williams news. I'm liking that he's actually Matthew MMW that he's doing, right? So it's sort of like building upon maybe the legacy of the kind of HTF, Hiroshi, Tinker, and Fraser Cook platform, right? And doing his own collaboration that way. And I also like the idea that all these new people, these new guys, they really know how to like brand themselves. So I think Sammy Ross is doing the same sort of thing with a Cold War. So he's got his own studio, he does his own stuff under his own name. And he's got obviously a Cold War. Then there's obviously the polyurethane optics, whatever that name is called, for the kind of core streetwear stuff that he kind of gives to the kids, quote unquote, that can't afford it. And he actually does it for the kids. You remember back in the day when Virgil was always like, oh, I'm for the kids. And he'd sell you a rugby flannel with 23 print on the back of it for $500, right? Like, that wasn't for the kids, right? Even though, to be fair to Virgil, I think he's learned from that and he does go above and beyond to give unknown kids a platform, right? He'll get a stylist in that no one knows from Twitter to come and work on his show. He'll get some kids a designer graphic, right? He does give everyone an opportunity. But that early era of Off-White, or Off-Pyrex, when he was kind of basically using kids to kind of give himself clout, was not the most tasteful, but he's learned from it. But I also like that someone like a Sammy Ross kind of backs it up. You know, he's got an actual line that's kind of like a subsidiary line that he uses to kind of pump product out to kids who don't have much money. And I like the fact that Matthew Williams does the same thing with his brand and doesn't dilute it by kind of using a Leaks logo or a Leaks name and associating it with Nikes and stuff. He kind of uses his own name and puts them on there, and I think it's pretty cool. And most of the stuff that he's doing with these MMW moniker seems like it's kind of centered around outdoors athletic fitness wear, which is quite interesting too, direction to go into, which kind of puts him in the same company as like a Jun Takahashi, right, with a kind of Gayokusu, however you pronounce it, collection, which maybe might be his overall vision. I always kind of got the impression that Virgil and Matthew were framing their kind of careers around what Jun and Nigo kind of have done, right? The idea that they were able to kind of sit in both, maybe not less so Nigo, more so Jun, he's able to sit in both areas of like fashion with a capital F and obviously streetwear. I think that's something that, because he still does it, right? John Undercover. Does John still do that? John Undercover is basically the kind of Uniqlo version of Undercover, for the lack of a better term. It's still quite expensive, but you still get the same aesthetic. There's still kind of the same, the codes, the same ethos, the same taste level on those kind of clothing. Anyway, let's go back to Matthew Williams. He's got a new shoe here previewed from Hypebeast. It's the Matthew Williams teases up and coming Nike Zoom MW4, which is pretty interesting for a shoe. Again, weird sole. I'm not sure if there's a bubble there. I like the fact that it's kind of got this weird wraparound thing at the bottom. It looks like it's been constructed out of lava or something. Kind of reminds me of a CCP shoe, maybe in that respect. But I like the fact that it's, I think it's an entirely new model. I'm not too sure. I haven't read the text here from Hypebeast. But it looks like it might be an entirely new model. Matthew Williams here has taken, this is an article from Hypebeast, I'm quickly going to read here for you guys, has taken to Instagram to further tease the up-and-coming Nike Zoom MMW sneaker. Previously unveiled at Nike 2020 Future Sport Forum, the new set of images give us a better look at the shoe's multiple mesh panels, exaggerated heel, and elongated opening representative of the heel tunnel found on Nike's Shox Gravity silhouette. Okay, nice. There's currently no official info on it, but yeah, it looks like an interesting shoe, right? So again, he's taken a maybe a model that already exists and really gave it his Matthew Williams touch or Elite's kind of design ethic code. It looks fucking incredible, doesn't it? Is that like a pull tab? I like the fact that it's got this mad tread that kind of wraps around underneath it. You've got these insane pull tabs on it. Is that a bit of branding there? Oh yeah, MMW here on the toe looks really incredible. MMW there too. I wonder who's paying a homage to with MMW, because you could either just have it MMW, right, Matthew Williams, but he always goes by MMW. MMW. I wonder what the middle M is for. Maybe it's a leg, maybe something's paying homage to family or something, but it's quite cool. The shoe looks pretty cool. Little video of him on. Wow, they look amazing. Whoa, they look nuts. You see, you remember, I think I remember speaking to my friend about this, right? The thing I hate about fashion shoes, the thing I hate about people in fashion design trainers, is that they try and just replicate what's already been out. They'll go to the archive and just try and pull out a 90s, an 80s reference and just apply it to a shoe that already exists nowadays, right? What I would like to a fashion people to do, which is why I really like the Triple S, was that it was a fashion shoe. It was that their crazy interpretation of what a fashion shoe would look like. If you're going to be a fashion house or a fashion designer and use the resources of a sneaker company, don't waste it by just taking something from the archive or redesigning a colorway. Go there and actually use their design team, their research and development team, their materials, the testing, to actually create something mad that you can never... Because I think I remember hearing from someone that has a brand that the actual most expensive thing to produce or to kind of manufacture is shoes, right? Because effectively you're having to make a last for each size, which is why most fashion companies don't do half sizes, because the margins are just incredibly low. And obviously you're gonna have to pay a lot outlay initially. I think is even worse than maybe clothing in terms of getting the molds done. So the fact that you can go into a Nike studio, you go to an Oregon, you can go to like an idea lab and work with those guys, people who have kind of studied this shit outside of the trend, just studied footwear design, and I can maybe make your thing come to life, right? It reminds me like of a scene out of the Karl Lagerfeld documentary where he's just sketching and he hands it to a seamstress and she just makes it. Like, if you could do that in your fashion company, take advantage of it and make something nuts, because this looks incredible, man. It looks wild. Fuck yeah, man. I'm all for it. I'm all for that shoe. That looks fucking insane. And again, it's a running, it's a performance shoe, right? It's like going to be a fitness running shoe that people are going to be able to wear. I'm definitely going to be into that, man. That looks nuts. Because again, when you go out and running, like, everyone's wearing the same stuff. It's all the same sort of neons, same sort of silhouettes for the most part. Chunky sole. Everyone's kind of making their version of a hookah, of a hookah one one. Everyone's making their version of like a Nike Vaporfly 4%. So the fact that this looks nothing like those shoes is something I'm game for, man. Wow. No date of release so far, but happy to see them. Let's go to his Instagram quickly and check if he uploaded anything since that post, because this has been a while back. But wow, they look beautiful. Nothing so far. Here, there he is standing with the boss, obviously. Man like HF. I would like that one because, you know, he's a legend. Jesus Christ. Amazing. But yeah, big up. Matthew for just making amazing stuff, man. Just amazing stuff. He's really killing with the leaks. And if the Givenchy rumors are to be believed, then he's going to be a great addition to that legacy, to that storied house. I mean, hopefully we'll see another side of him, what else he can do in that regard, because I think he's kind of aced this kind of luxury streetwear kind of field. Maybe the next kind of avenue is to go high fashion with a capital F in it. Who knows?